did horse riding and swimming. Lots of money, not sure if it all worked, but it kept her busy after school.
My kids think that we consider budget, which is a consideration because it is expensive. But for me, it's also time. Firstly, schoolwork is priority. So they need to have time and energy to do that properly. And then the second thing is what, if they want to do an activity, we look at it and we say, is it something that you're good at and something you enjoy? Because just doing something because your friends are doing it, it's not on. So we've got our Laura child who's extremely talented at art, and she does an art lesson. And we've kind of limit them to one paid for activity, doing what they do. Ilse with the netball, she's very good at it and she loves it, so she does that. So we try and get them to do the stuff that they enjoy and to work on the talents that we know they have and get them to explore that. And it's really hard to cut it down because I might be biased because they're my kids, but I believe they're extremely talented and in more than one area.
I think just from a busyness of your household perspective, the first thing I would check is how would it fit in? What would it do to the atmosphere in our house? Would it make it too busy? Would it make it stressful? And then we'd immediately say no. We want kids that get exposed to a lot of stuff, but as the mummy gets flustered, then the kids get flustered and then there's fights in the house and discipline goes out the window and disrespect kind of sneaks its way in there. So I think also to purposely leave enough time during the day for a little bit of boredom and creativity and to be quiet.
My son has two activities that he really likes, that he's very passionate about, and he's very committed to that. And I don't often get asked. He doesn't want to do every second activity that come across our path. So, but I guard our, I try to simplify our lives because the busyness just creates chaos and anxiety. So I really think that less is more. I'd rather put in a bigger effort in those activities that he does take part in.
G'day and welcome again to Parenting on Purpose. And now we're going to speak about something that all of us as parents sometime in our life will deal with. We've got those busy years where everybody's schedule in the family adds to a very busy household. And if we don't watch it, we can be like a train station, just running past one another, missing each other completely. So I'm sure all of us have tasted some of that. And there are some particular years when they start getting into the sports, into the extramurals, and we're just running our legs off if we don't watch, because on all sides, the community will tell us, but you have to do this, and you have to do this, and you have to do this. How do we sift through all of those things? Now, Andrew and Belinda, you've got three adult kids. You've raised them very well. I've actually, Devin asked me the other day to sing at the wedding. It's the second child going to be married. We're all excited about that. But how did you navigate those days? You had three very sporty boys. How did you get through it?
We do remember those weekends where we had to be in three different places at three different times. And we'd often have to, I would have to take the one, Belinda would have to take the other, and jostle around for the third. So it was... You know, it was a challenge.
Yeah.
I think our boys played soccer, so that was Saturday mornings. But the more difficult thing was when they played tennis.
Yeah.
And because that was entire weekends, and often it was holidays as well.
Yeah.
Because if you play at that level, and they played in a lot of provincial tournaments. You earn points by stepping onto the court. And so you miss a tournament and you lose out on points.
Yeah.
So a lot of our holidays had to be geared around tennis tournaments.
Sure.
And so it was busy for a period of time. And I think maybe we were more relieved when they got to the point where they said, look, this is not going to be our future. We're not going to become professional tennis players.
Yeah.
So we'd like to slow down a little bit. But during that period of time, we had to make the best of what we could. If we were at a tournament, and often we'd have to wait for hours when it was raining, we'd go out for breakfast together and we'd turn it into an event. And we had to sort of work at doing that, at clearing our calendar to fit in with theirs so that they were never alone at those tournaments, and trying to work around that.
I think it does boil down to priorities at the end of the day. You can be incredibly busy, but you need to decide what are the things that I'm not going to compromise on.
Yes.
And I think that's a very important discussion.
Name us a couple of those.
Well, one of them was that we really strongly believed in family time around a meal, evening meal. It happened to be dinner time was the one that we said, right, no television. But, well, we didn't really have phones in those days, but if we had today, we would have said phones off. This is family time now, and we talk to one another face to face.
Can I just say the opposite? If you haven't decided that,
then you wouldn't do it.
It would have fallen by the wayside, isn't it?
And we used to see people, grab their meal on a tray in front of the TV, and that's how that family decided to operate. But we decided that it was that meal was very, very important, and we used to. It wasn't really a game, but we used to call it one up, one down.
Yes.
And what that really meant, we used to say to each child, what was the up today in the sense?
Best thing.
What was the best thing? What inspired you? What was good? What was lovely? What was good repute? That kind of idea.
Mm.
And then they would tell us. And then the one down was, what was that thing that disappointed you or made you sad?
The worst thing that happened today.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then that was one way of us remaining connected to what was happening in our children's lives.
Yes.
And they loved it. It always became, in fact, when family friends came, we used to include them in the one up and one down. And to us, that was a huge priority. That it's almost like a daily check-in.
Yes.
Mm. Yeah. We had to work hard to make it happen because often their soccer practice went on quite late into the evening, and I was the one sitting in the car at the soccer practice, doing homework with this one while that one was practicing, etc. And you still have to come home and then make supper and that. So we did get used to eating very late as a family.
Yeah.
But we still ate. And I remember distinctly we had a young man who stayed with us for 2 years. And from a background or a family where family meals just weren't the thing. Mm. And it upset him enormously in the beginning when he used to dish up and wanted to take it off to his room. And we said,
you come like back. That.
But interestingly enough, in the second year that he was with us, it became so much a part of what he valued that on one occasion, I think there was a sports match or something happening and we'd said, okay, you can dish up and we can watch. It was a tennis final or something like that. And he was up in arms saying, no, we can't, we don't do that. We've got to eat together at the table. And so it becomes a culture and a value. And it was one thing, that I think we had to sort of put a peg in the ground because for those 5 or 10 years, life was
you might have completely
exceptionally busy.
Yeah.
I think in the age we're living in, maybe there are some parents who don't fall into the trap of getting too busy, but it is difficult because I almost want to say you are going to get to some point where you are really busy. And then you need to decide. Sometimes it gets to a point where it's actually really bad. It's the pressure is just too much on the children. Like Zoe was swimming and she was just overtraining and she hurt her shoulder. And at that point, we had to decide whether we just going to give her cortisone injections and go for an operation, or if we're going to take a more conservative route and just do physiotherapy and Pilates. And because I remember one of my friends saying, well, she needs to live with that shoulder for the rest of her life. So, you need to have the wisdom to know when to stop and when to take the pressure away from your child.
Yes. another value that I obviously noticed in your family, being part of the church. Your kids were with me in junior youth and then into senior youth.
Yes.
And they always attended on a Friday.
Yeah. Yeah.
And they were always here on a Sunday.
Yeah. Garth, I think that for us was a really important priority, especially during those teenage years, is that I think Belinda and I both saw it was really important that our teenage boys had friends, godly friends, you know, as part of the youth group.
Yeah.
And we thought it was extremely important that they made friends with people that, you know, were godly other kids.
Yeah.
They had similar values. Mm. And that is so important, especially, I think it's even more important today, is that you have a handle on who the friends of your children are.
Yeah.
And there were many things that we wouldn't have allowed them to do over the weekends. And it helped for them to, when everybody else was talking about what they were doing on a Friday night, to be able to say, well, we have youth.
Yeah.
Because they automatically had a place to go to on a Friday night.
Friends
they were automatically doing something that was fun and that was whatever. So it wasn't, well, we're not allowed to go anywhere and we're going to sit at home.
Yeah.
Mm. It gave them a place to be.
Yeah.
And I mean, you know, we also, I was involved with the youth for many years when it didn't, when it couldn't happen here or there wasn't anything, it happened at home because we really valued that kind of input, that kind of opportunity.
You made it a priority.
For the boys, yeah.
And again, with sports and sync, that can easily land out.
Yeah.
It will
easily take the place if you don't have purposefully a value that this is important, this is a priority for us. I remember at some stage, Tessa wanted to do a particular sport. And it just so happened that the tournaments for that sport always landed on a Sunday.
Mm.
And it was just for us as a family an automatic no. Yeah. And she yearned for it. She really wanted to do that. And we had to say, listen, as a family, unfortunately, that's going to clash with our schedule. Because we want to be in church together on a Sunday. And she had to make peace with that.
Yeah.
And praise God she did.
I think that, you know, busyness is a fact of life today. And I think it's not going to get slower. I don't think any of us think that life's going to get slower. It's going to get faster. But I think everyone needs to stop and regularly review how busy am I?
Yes.
And what am I busy about?
Yeah,
maybe these two ways of looking at it is as a family, how busy are we as a family?
Mm.
But also, I think husband and wife need to think, how busy am I at work?
Yes.
Because that also steals away time. And you need to assess and say, well, we've got to keep a healthy balance. Because the years that you have with your children are actually very few. You know, when you look back, I know everyone... While you're in it, you think, are these years ever going to end?
Yeah.
But when it's past, you look back and you think it was really, really short.
Period.
So you have a very short time to actually influence and impact your children.
Yeah.
So if you are tied up with a lot of other busyness stuff,
yeah.
no matter how good they might be, at the end of the day, you know, bringing up your children in the...
Yeah. I'm so glad that you land on that because in every single topic that we land on, in parenting, we always have to look at modeling.
Yeah.
What am I modeling?
Yeah.
I brought a couple of questions here. You remember, we've done this for our life group a couple of times, Alarm Bells for Readers. It's by a man called John Maxwell. And it's a whole long list of questions, but it's just heart-searching questions. And it comes down to my motives, my priorities. It just drills down to that level. But particularly in terms of busyness, I think it's something that we as parents can look into as well. Is my personal walk with God up to date? Am I hearing from God daily? Can others sense that I've spent time in His glorious presence? Am I keeping my path straight? Am I living out those things that I tell others are most important? Does my diary reflect my priorities? Am I asking myself the hard questions? Why do I do the things that I do? What's my motives? So for us as parents, we have to have the same challenge and say, what am I busy at? What am I allowing to fill my diary, my schedule? And then broader, we still have that responsibility with our children to say, what is filling our schedule as a family? Are we forcing each other? Are we missing each other in the busyness of life? And may God give us wisdom with those decisions as we move along.